imagine me and you, I do. I think about you day and night. It's only right to think about the girl you love and hold her tight. So happy together. If I should call you up, invest a dime, and you say you belong to me, and ease my mind, imagine how the world could be so very fine, so happy.
Yes, this is Chris Heidel, Herb FM Radio. We're doing a special show this evening for the Arena Football Week 7. A lot of big games this weekend. You got Albany taking on Baltimore. You got Atlantic City Blackjacks. They're going to be taking on Columbus in Columbus. And also you got the Ballard taking on the Soul this Sunday afternoon. So we have Coffee Jones with us, who covers the Atlantic City Blackjacks. He's also the analyst for the radio. So, Coffee, thanks for joining us. Last week, a good win for the Blackjacks, beating Baltimore by 1 point on a block field goal. So, let's talk about the momentum that the team has going into this weekend.
I mean, there's a lot of momentum When you think about how that game was won, it comes down to the wire. You got a one-point ball game going into the fourth quarter, and no team scored in the fourth quarter. You got to give hats off to Sergio Gilliam, defensive coordinator of the Black Jacks, and obviously the defensive coordinator, Sam Walker, of the Baltimore Brigade, because both defenses just turned it up a notch. And for Atlantic City to come out with that win, it was really improbable. When you think about a situation with 30-second timing rule, they're sitting with the ball on the doorstep of the goal line. They run a couple plays. They try to throw a fade route to the best jump ball guy, Joe Fine, but hopefully the best wide receiver in the game. And Joe Hills, one-on-one against Marvin Skipper. Marvin Ross holds his own, keeps Joe Hills from scoring, doesn't get a penalty called, and then finally, when they set up a fourth down and kick that field goal, Antoine Dillon, the guy who's got championship pedigree, being with the Arizona Rattlers, and he's won a couple titles with them, he shows up. You know, I tried to force him later, earlier in the game, down in the red zone area to keep them out of the end zone, and he comes up with the biggest play, I think the biggest play of his career. I mean, he's won championships, but he made a single-handedly won that game in the fourth quarter for the Black Jacks to get them back to 3-3 and back in the playoffs as of right now.
Yeah, I was watching the game from my parents' house, and Baltimore was up pretty big in the second quarter going into the third quarter, scoring 20 points in the second quarter. And I was like, wow, Baltimore's probably going to do this, you know, winning up there in Atlantic City. And, you know, like you said, you know, I forgot to watch the fourth quarter, but, you know, it just seemed like, you know, that game was competitive, and these both teams are very competitive with each other.
Yeah, and both teams, I mean, obviously they just played each other 2 weeks prior to that. Like in the same town, a lot of these guys, I mean, listen, Kendrick Gaines, Randy Hibbert, these guys are both Panther Games members just last year. There's a lot of familiarity on both sides of football, and we talk about a guy like Randy Hibbert, as cool as they can find at the quarterback position. He's a former MVP in the league. He's played the last two Arena Bowls. He made enough plays to win that game, man. It would have been pretty upsetting for him to lose that game the way he did, you know, with a couple of his receivers trying to make plays after the catch and end up fumbling the football and then fighting for the goal line. I mean, it's a tough situation, but Randy Hibbert did what he had to do. He knew what you were going to get against Baltimore. He's going to get tight coverage with Joe Powell, John Story, who was just coming off of what I thought was the best game of his career against Philadelphia last Sunday. He comes out, he doesn't play in the first quarter, but he comes out and has a pretty good game. He makes, you know, a couple mistakes on the corner routes. You know, LeVar Brown got open down the middle of the field in the zone coverage. But they did what they had to do offensively to put themselves in a position to win that game. Their line up front let them down. It wasn't even on the kicker. He may have missed an extra point early in the game. He put him down by one, put the pressure on himself, but he didn't get an opportunity to try to amend for that mistake with the kickoff blocked by Dillon.
Yeah, we've seen a lot this year, a lot of missed extra points. So I guess, are these place kickers? I know I talked to you about this a couple weeks ago, but it seems like these place kickers are not you know, taking an extra couple seconds before they kick the football. It seems like they're in a rush or something to get the ball through the uprights.
Man, listen, I don't honestly know. I've never kicked in a game. I don't understand the dynamics of it, the mechanics of it. You know, I hang around with Jaws and a lot of people in the NFL films. He always talks about Randy Brown, who's the former kicking coach of the Baltimore Ravens. He explains why they were so good when they won their Super Bowl run. They've always had Pro Bowl kickers because Randy Brown was able to keep the mechanics of the position, foot placement, where your head's supposed to be, how you strike the ball, all that different stuff that goes into it. That's above my pay grade. He knows how to explain that. I don't know what's going on with the kickers. And I always laugh at it when you watch the extra point and the ball goes right between the bars and the slack net for 58 yards away, yet you get 12 yards away for the next point, and they're shaking them right and left. And I don't know if it's just the curve of the ball, you know, something like a golf swing where you see that ball curve, but they can find it down the middle from deep distance. But when it gets up close and there's actually money on the line, you know, a lot of guys are starting to shake. You've seen the issues in Baltimore, Philadelphia. A lot of different teams are struggling, and it's going to come down to a situation. You've seen it happen many times, where a team misses that extra point early in the game, and before you know it, you're down by 8, and you're chasing points. You miss another one, you're down by 9, and it's a two-score game. That changes the complexity of things. And it's not like the NFL, where they've made it more difficult. The dimension of a field goal in the AFL has been the same since the creation of the game. So you got the opportunity to get in the arena. You got to be able to work on it, because it's going to be crucial, whether it's the first drive of the game or the last play of the game, like we've seen in Baltimore.
Exactly. Well, Coffee, thank you so much for taking some time tonight, and enjoy the games this weekend. I know you guys have to travel out to Columbus, Ohio, to play the Destroyers, who are looking for their first win, but that's going to be an interesting game as well.
I definitely think it is. On a quick note on that game, if you talk about teams facing a trap game, this would be one that's direct before. You got a team that hasn't won a game all season long, a team that you beat, you know, sadly earlier in the season at home. They're coming off a tough loss to Philadelphia, game that they thought they could be able to compete with. You just come off an amazing win. You got an emotional high. This would be a situation where you could see a letdown. De'Ron James has to have this team prepared. Randy Hibbert has to be focused. Norton, Dillon, those guys on defense have to be prepared to go out to Columbus and try to get a win, because you can't look past anybody in this league. They've got talent on defense. Grant Russell can make some plays. You see some new receivers start to emerge, the Stevens and those guys. And Guerrero, the way he can return some kicks, can make some plays as well. They should have won their last home game against Washington. That crowd should be pretty fun when we go out there to Columbus. I'm excited to be there.
Exactly. Well, Coffee, good luck this weekend. Enjoy the games. We'll talk to you soon.
No problem. Thank you, guys. Anytime.
All right. We'll be right back here on the Sports Desk here on, the Arena Football Weekly, right here on With Them Radio.
Crackling rosy, get on board. We gonna ride till there ain't no more. We'll go taking it slow. And Lord, don't you know, I'll have my time with a poor man's lady. Hitching on a twilight train, ain't nothing here that I care to take alone.